Hey everyone, my name is Will. Welcome to Room and Goods. So those who own an Oculus Quest or who is about to own a Quest will notice that the stock head strap can be uncomfortable. So in order to fix that, I got the Esmin adjustable head strap, or otherwise known as the Halo strap for the Oculus Quest. So today, I'm going to break it down to the reasons why I actually got this, as well as the installation process, and my final verdict about the Esmin head strap. So the package that was delivered includes one head strap and one adjustable headband, and it currently costs $49.99. I'll put a link in the description if you're interested in head strap. Now, there's a couple reasons why I actually got this. First thing was about comfort. By using the original straps from the Oculus Quest, a lot of the weight from the headset was front facing, which can get pretty uncomfortable after about an hour or so of playing time. Plus, it shows because you actually see marks around your face after you finish playing a game. So with the head strap, it took a lot of the weight off and redistributed the weight to the forehead area, which by the way is nicely padded. It also includes the pads in the rear that helps cushion the back of your head. Now the padding is made of leather and a foam cushion, which was soft to the touch and wraps the contour of your head pretty nicely. The padding was just thick enough where it relieved much of the pressure or weight against the forehead. Even after wearing it for about 2 or 3 hours, it just left a light mark around the forehead. I was actually pleasantly surprised how breathable the material was. I assumed that I would be sweating after a long periods of gameplay, but actually it wasn't too bad. The pad was warm, but it wasn't too hot that I needed to wipe off the sweat. It was just a bit moist. But I suppose it depends how hard you're playing in VR. Which brings me to my next point. Even if you left any bacteria, oils, or sweat on the padding, it's actually pretty easy to clean. You can wipe it down with a disinfectant wipe or simply with a soft cloth. The material wasn't absorbent like the original foam padding on the Oculus Quest, so it was actually easy to wipe down, so no complaints there. Now let's move on to the installation process. Honestly, it wasn't too bad. It took me about 15 minutes from taking off the original head strap to putting the new one on. So step one is taking off the original face mask by simply pulling it up. Next step is taking off the original strap from each side. So undo the Velcro and slide the strap out as much as you can all the way to the edge. Now if you can't pull anymore or push anymore, just put your thumb underneath that insert and twist your thumb just a bit to push it up and then pull it out. Now let's go over to the other side and do the same thing. Again, undo the Velcro and let's start to pull this out. And slide it all the way until you can't anymore. Again, put your thumb underneath that insert and twist your thumb a bit and pull it out. Okay, next is pulling out the headband. This is actually easy, just simply pull it out from the insert. If you do have a bit of trouble, just go to the other side and push it forward and then try pulling it out again. And that's it as far as taking out the original head strap. Now moving on to installing the new head strap. First step is simply sliding this over to these brackets where the original strap used to be. You can slide it all the way up if you like, but don't worry about it too much as you'll be adjusting this when you're actually wearing the headset. For now, just make sure it's actually secure so you can adjust it later. Now next is the headband. So as far as securing the back, it wasn't too difficult. Just slide it into the insert and secure it with the Velcro. Next, be sure to put the headband over the head strap. So this part can be difficult if you try to insert the headband without any additional tools. So what I did was use the corner of the headband and slide it in the insert as much as I can. Once you see the corner, you can just hold it there in place and then take some pliers or you can use tweezers and pull the rest of the headband right through. I'm sure there's other techniques, but this was the easiest method that I found. After that, just simply attach the Velcro onto the band and then you could attach the face mask back onto the headset by snapping that back in place. Now adjustments of the head strap is pretty flexible. You have a few options you can do in terms of adjusting the head strap. The obvious one is using the rear knob to adjust according to your head size by loosening or tightening the knob. Second option is the headband that sits on top of your head. That can help with relieving the pressure on your face by actually having the headset lift up. Now the third option, you can adjust the angle of the headset. That's important because when you put on the headset, you can actually tilt the headset up just a bit to again lift it off away from your face. And lastly, you can actually adjust it where you can bring the headset closer to you by sliding these brackets in a bit more. Now, as far as adjusting the head strap, it will take trial and error before you can actually find the right fit. But to really maximize the support, try putting this part of the head strap on the base of your head. I actually think that's one of the more important things to point out to correctly fit it around your head. Personally, I played with the adjustment for at least 10 or 15 minutes before I actually found the right fit. And I did test it while playing games like Synth Rider and O-Shape, which are more active games, and it did stay on with not much issues of slipping. Also, I want to quickly point out that the audio did sound a bit different. It's actually now more hollow sounding now that we removed the original head strap. But after a few days of playing around with it, you tend to get adjusted to the sounds, but it was definitely noticeable when you first put your headset on. However, if normally you use headphones, this is not going to make much of a difference. Now let's move on to the build quality of the head strap. I'm going to actually compare it with the HTC Vive Deluxe Audio Strap just so we have some reference in terms of design and material. But keep in mind guys, this strap is $100 that you can use to attach it on your Oculus Quest, but it does need additional components in order to attach it onto the headset. So overall, the main components of the Esmin head strap is at a decent quality. As you can see, it does have a smooth texture finish around the padded area, very similar to the HTC Vive. However, on the Esmin's head strap, you'll notice a thin and flexible rail which seems a bit flimsy. This rail basically allows the person to adjust the head strap forward and back by turning the knob. Now, if you look at the rail on the HTC Vive head strap, it's pretty close in thickness, but the HTC Vive feels and looks a bit thicker. Also, there is additional material encasing the rail, so it does feel a bit more solid here, but it also serves an additional purpose of holding the floating adjustable headphones. As far as the knob on the Esmin head strap, it does make a clicking sound when you tighten it, versus the HTC Vive knob, it doesn't have that sharp clicking sound, and it seems a bit smoother when turning the knob. Now the Esmin head strap, pivot points in the front and one in the middle are both attached by metal screws, which makes it a bit more solid, and that's actually similar to HTC Vive's head strap's pivot points, which is also a metal screw. Overall, I do think the Esmin head strap feels pretty solid and nicely contours the forehead and the back of their head. However, the HTC Vive head strap seems to cradle the base of the head a bit more, which you can visually see it from the head strap's design. It made it a bit easier to get into the headset with less adjustments. Now, let's talk about the headband. If you compare to the two, the HTC head strap is obviously a lot wider and it has a thicker material versus the Esmin strap, which has a thinner material that has a combination of a cotton type of material on top and a smooth plastic on the backside. So the HTC Vive headband itself seemed to be more supportive in terms of lifting it away from your face. Now, as far as the padding that I mentioned earlier, you can see the Esmin head strap has a thicker and softer padding which helps relieve the pressure from the forehead to the backside of the head, compared to the Vive version which has a thin styrofoam padding. Also, as a side note, if you have an additional face cover like the VR Cover's silicone version, you could also add that in as well to make it a bit more comfortable. Plus, the silicone material is sweatproof and it's cool against your skin, but there are a couple things that did bother me about the cover. For one, there wasn't enough material right underneath the nose area, so this part can come off pretty easily, so the flaps here can sit on top of your nose if your headset slides down, which can prevent you from breathing normally. But with the Esmin head strap, it can help with that issue by angling it up just a bit and pulling it away from your nose. So overall, would I recommend the Esmin head strap? Well, due to its price point, the overall fit, which I know can be subjective because of the different head sizes and the improved comfort, I would say yes. If I have to give it a rating, I would give it 4 out of 5 stars. Again, you definitely have to play with the headset by adjusting the different components. If you're the only user of the headset, it's not really a big deal because you don't have to adjust it all the time, so it really depends on your situation. Now, the strap did definitely make my VR experience a much better experience. I no longer feel much of the pressure on my face, which is definitely a welcoming feeling. So if you're interested or would like to check it out, I'll put a link in the description. As always guys, if you liked the video, press the like button and consider subscribing. Talk to you guys later.